Dear W124 fans and friends, it's Ivica speaking, and at the beginning I would ask you kindly to subscribe to the channel. Our current topic are the hoses on our beloved car, so stay till the end of the video. This is one of my most negative experiences with this car. In this video, I would like to show you an example how a neglected car looks like concerning the hoses. If I started counting everything I have replaced until now on this poor car, the video would be hours long. I would never ever sell someone a car, not just this car, any other car with so many issues as I have had them until now. So let's just talk about the hoses. The hoses are made of rubber, and with the age the rubber becomes stiff and needs replacement. This is one of those things that you replace once. So the former owners didn't want to spare me that privileged item. At first, as I bought the car, I had issues with this hose. Pain in the butt for 7 years was a 15 centimeter hose and always driving on LPG. Whenever having an issue with the car stalling, I knew it was about the hose, but I never knew what it is for. As for the previous owner, as well, he didn't even want to know what the hose is for. He only knew that when the car stalls, he had to pop up the hood and stick like this. Stick it back again where it was supposed to be. The hose itself, the crankcase breather hose, connects the idle control valve and the airflow sensor plate from underneath. So, if you unscrewed all the bolts on the sensor plate and all the nuts, and if you took the whole assembly and turned it upside down, you could see a rubber seal with two holes. The airflow meter housing. One of these holes connects to the throttle, and the second one is connected to the idle control valve. When it comes to detonation, the part falls down from the sensor plate and the car don't start up at all. And it was this part particularly. It falls like this when it comes to detonation, so the car don't start up at all. This is how the hose was laying when I decided to replace it, with two hose clamps on it. Can you believe this? Even the mechanic who has been maintaining my car told me that he can place the hose clamp and the hose won't fall down anymore, etc. I mean, bunch of crap. Look at this. Just look at this. As you see, one part of the hose, of this hose, is stiffer than the other one, you see. And one part is narrower than the other. Look at this. Look at my little finger. Here. Going in with no problems. Look the second one, the forward one. Well, I would have to stick it down a little. See for yourselves. And there was a fool that tightened the hose with the hose clamp like crazy and deformed the hose itself. Can you imagine this? The Mercedes-Benz engineers didn't even predict the hose clamp to be tightened up on each side. This hose is very cheap, concerning the fact you have to replace it each 20 years. I mean, really. The other three parts of the hose connect the engine, the idle control valve, and one part you must take out when accessing the engine. It goes into the air filter housing, as well as the ventilation hose that comes from the fuel pressure regulator. One part of this assembly, look. One part was taped because the hose was tearing apart. It is, look at it, it is literally taped. Just look at this. The idiot didn't want to replace the hose. This solution was cheaper for him to do. In the engine, I still have some parts of the broken hose. But there are people saying that they didn't marry a bunch of iron. She, meaning the car, has to serve him or her. I agree. But if you don't respect your car, the car don't respect you as well. These cars are old, they need care and love. And as people say, an old car and a young woman will always need to be maintained. So, if you liked this video, share it, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done it yet, hit the like button, and if you think there is something I didn't mention, or if you disagree with me, let me know in the comment section down below. And till the next video, happy Mercedes-y.